Good morning students, today we are going to start the topic admixtures in concrete. So what is admixture? Admixtures are the material other than the basic ingredients of concrete added to the concrete mix immediately before or during mixing to modify some specific properties of concrete in fresh or hardened state. Functions of admixtures are to accelerate or retard the initial setting of concrete, to increase the strength of concrete, to improve the workability, to increase the durability of concrete, to control the alkali aggregate expansion, to improve the penetration and pumpability of concrete, to reduce the segregation and bleeding, to increase the bond between old and new layer, to protect the concrete by corrosion and chemical attacks, to produce the color in concrete. Types of admixtures are, first is the chemical admixture and the second one is the mineral admixture. So first is accelerator. An admixture is used to speed up initial setting of concrete is called an accelerator. These are added to concrete either to increase the rate of hydration of cement or to shorten the setting time of concrete. The most commonly used accelerator is CaCl2, which accelerates primarily the early strength development of concrete. This admixture is sometimes used when concrete is to be placed at low temperature, that is 2 degree to 4 degree Celsius, or when urgent repair work is required. CaCl2 can generally be used in amount up to 2% by mass of cement. The admixture uniformly distributed throughout the mix, and this is best achieved by dissolving the admixture in the mixing water. The other less commonly used accelerators are NaCl, Na2SO4, NaOH, Na2CO3, K2SO4 and KOH. The second is retarders. These are the admixture which delay the setting time of concrete. The retarders are used in hot weather where the normal setting time is shortened by the higher temperature and is preventing the formation of cold joints between successive lifts. They are also used in grouting oil wells where depth is about 600 meters. Sugar, carbohydrates, derivatives such as soluble starch, soluble zinc, salt and soluble borates are used as retarders. Very small dosage of order of 0.05 to 0.1% of cement mass is enough. About 0.05% of the sugar by mass of cement will delay the initial setting time about 4 hours. 0.2 to 0.1% of sugar by mass of cement virtually prevent the setting of cement. Retarders tend to increase the plastic shrinkage because plastic stage is intended, but drying shrinkage is unaffected. Water reducer plasticizers. These admixtures are used for three purposes. First, to achieve high strength by decreasing the water cement ratio at same workability. Second one, to achieve the same workability by decreasing the cement content. Third, to increase the workability at same water cement ratio. There are two types of water reducers are mostly used. First is hydroxylated carboxylic acid. These type of admixture can increase bleeding in high workable concrete. Second, lignosulfonic acid. This type of admixture usually improves cohesiveness because they entrain air. Now second is superplasticizer. Superplasticizers are used to produce flowing concrete in situation where placing in accessible locations in floor, pavement, slab or where very rapid placing is required. A second use of superplasticizer is to produce very high strength concrete. By adding of superplasticizer, dispersing of cement starts. The dispersing action is mainly promoted by sulfonic acid being absorbed on the surface of cement particles, causing them to become negatively charged and thus mutually repulsive. There is an increase in workability by addition of superplasticizer. The slump is more than 200 mm. The improved workability produced by the superplasticizer is of short duration. After 30 to 90 minutes, the workability returns to normal. For this reason, the superplasticizer should be added to the mix immediately prior to placing. Admixture and construction chemicals. Admixture is defined as the material other than sand, cement and aggregates that is used as an ingredient of concrete and is added to the batch immediately before or during mixing. Admixtures are plasticizers, superplasticizers, retarders, accelerators, pozzolaning or mineral admixtures, damp proofing and waterproofing admixtures, air detaining admixtures, workability admixtures, grouting admixtures, bonding admixtures, coloring admixtures. Now, first is plasticizers. Water reducers. A high degree of workability is required in situation like deep dams, thin walls of water retaining structures and with high percentage of steel reinforcement, column and beam junction. The basic products constituting the plasticizers are as follows. First, anionic surfactants such as lignosulfonates and their modification and derivative salts of sulfonates, hydrocarbons. Second, non-ionic surfactants such as polyol esters, acids, hydroxylate, carboxylic acid and their modification and derivatives. Other products such as carbohydrates, etc. Among these, calcium sodium and ammonium lignosulfates are mostly used. Plasticizers are used in the amount of 0.1 to 0.4% by weight of cement. Superplasticizers. The use of superplasticizers is practiced for production of flowing, self-leveling, self-compacting and the production of high strength and high performance concrete. Superplasticizers can produce at the same water cement ratio much more workable concrete than the plain ones. For the same workability, it permits the use of lower water cement ratio. As a consequence of increased strength with lower water cement ratio, it also permits a reduction of cement content. The superplasticizers produce homogeneous cohesive concrete generally without any tendency for segregation and bleeding. Classification of superplasticizers. Following are the few polymers which are commonly used as base for superplasticizers. First is sulfonated malleen formaldehyde condensates. Second, sulfonated naphthalene formaldehyde condensates. Third, modified lignosulfonates. New generation superplasticizers are acrylic polymer based, copolymer of carboxylic acrylic ester, cross-linked acrylic polymer, polycarboxylate ester, multi-carboxylate ether, combination of above. Retarders. The retarder is an admixture that slows down the chemical process of hydration so that concrete remains plastic and workable for a longer time than concrete without the retarders. Retarders are used to overcome the accelerating effect of high temperature on setting properties of concrete in hot weather concreting. Most commonly known retarder is CaSO4. Common sugar is one of the most effective retarding agents used as an admixture for delaying the setting time of concrete without detrimental effect on the ultimate strength. Retarding plasticizers. Many times this extent of retardation of setting time offered by admixture will not be sufficient. Instead of adding retarders separately, retarders are mixed with plasticizers or superplasticizer at the time of commercial production. ASTM type D and ASTM type G are some examples. Accelerators. Accelerating admixtures are added to concrete to increase the rate of early strand development in concrete to permit earlier removal of formwork. Second, reduce the required period of curing. Third, advance the time that a structure can be placed in service. Fourth, partially compensate for the retarding effect of low temperature during cold weather concreting. Third, in emergency repair work, most commonly used accelerator is CaCl2.